for your time. And we have some points to discuss. So speaker and the organizers, okay? So we are organizing these meetups on our capacity, okay? So we are not representing our companies or we are not marketing any product over here. Okay, so this presentation, you know, strictly a learning point of view and sharing knowledge with the community, okay? So whatever POCs we are discussing here, we are not assuring that it will work in every environment. You need to refer the documents, use of documents, I would say. So always there will be latest or up to date information over there. So please go ahead there. This presentation, this POCs, these are whatever POCs are going to discuss here. Those will be reference for you guys. Okay. So we are not responsible if it won't work in your environment. Okay. That's what that's what I wanted to enforce here. Then we have some housekeeping items. So definitely you'll get a recording of this meetup, okay, within 24 hours. And the most important part, please ask the questions, make it more interactive. This session is not a webinar, guys. So have, interactive kind of, whenever you have questions, please go ahead. Either you can go ahead in Q&A tab or in chat section, you can, write your questions. We'll try to answer those whenever you get a chance, okay? And last but not the least, very important, it's a bread and butter for the meetups leader, okay? Please give your feedback after the session. Please write your feedback, rate the session, and let us know in which area you wanted to see future sessions, okay? So that's what the housekeeping items are. Then there is a surprise. We'll be having a trivia quiz. Their top three guys will be, will be selected as winners. And then from the NewsArt site, you'll be receiving the vouchers for the training of your interest. So we'll be sharing the Google form. Okay. In that you can mention which training you wanted to go for. Okay. And then NewsArt will enroll for it. Okay. So this is the agenda. It's over to you, Sridharan.
Meanwhile, Ashish, are we asking, do we want to start the QA and ask them to post their questions in the QA or just in the chat itself?
Yeah, please go ahead and paste it in the chat. That will be
enough
for us.
So are you guys able to see my screen?
And just a second, Sridharan.
Yeah.
Do you have any questions, at this point? Okay. Any questions, guys? No. You can go ahead and start, Sridharan.
Yeah, thanks, Ashish.
Yeah, we can see your screen, Sridharan.
Yeah, okay, thanks. So once again, I welcome you all, guys. Okay, so this is the first time I'm presenting in a meetup, so please bear with me, okay? So we can cover these features one by one, auto scaling, then endpoint monitoring overview and the log management one by one. Okay. So if you have any questions, as Ashish and Amit, you can put up in the chat so that we can go through that. Yeah.
They're looking at that.
Hmm. Okay. So without wasting time, we can get started because these are all some huge and vast topics and be difficult to cover within this time. So let's get started. So the first one is first topic we are going to cover is auto scaling. So basically auto scaling is the feature which is present in our Anypoint platform. Okay, so it's basically to we can monitor the applications, okay, and automatically update the worker configuration either horizontally or vertically based on the policy we can configure. Okay, and in MuleSoft we have both the horizontal and vertical scaling possible, but we can't apply both for a single application. I will just show that how to apply all those things in the demo. Okay, so basically in vertical scaling, as you know, the worker size will be increased or decreased once the configured policy configuration is made. Okay, similarly in horizontal scaling, the number of workers will be added or removed based on the configuration. And guys, in order to use this auto scaling feature, right, you need to have a enterprise license agreement. So this is the basic need of using this auto scaling. Okay, and if you don't have this option as well, then you also have some manual thing like configuring your own integration to check for the CPU and memory usage, and based on the configuration, you can auto trigger in using the Anypoint REST APIs to scaling out or scaling up like that. Okay. So this is the basic thing of how we can of the check. I mean the checkpoints of how we can do the configuration for auto scaling. Okay. So for this, we can monitor the application in the runtime manager for the last 15 or 30 days. Okay, and we can see whether the CPU utilization is exceeding or memory utilization is exceeding, and and accordingly during the time we can go to the monitoring and see whether the request volume is high or the number of requests is getting high, and based on that we can apply the scaling. So this is the flow. Okay, I will just show in the our Anypoint platform how to configure. So for this I have basically logged into two accounts. Okay, so this demo org is my organization business unit, okay, which has the enterprise license as well as the Titanium subscription, and this is the trial account. Okay, it doesn't have any of these additional features. So let's log in to my trial account and show what's the present there.
So meanwhile, still one question from me. This auto scaling is even with the Titanium subscription, we won't get this auto scaling, isn't it? We need to actually, it's an on demand.
Yeah. Okay. We need to have the ELA license.
Okay. Cool. Thanks.
So actually, I have logged into my trial account, and if you look, we are having separate tabs under the settings. Okay. So one is runtime. Properties, insight, logging, and static APIs. Okay, and let me log into my org account, which has the ELA agreement as well. And let's take this API for example. Okay, actually, this API is making use of the online open API request.in. Okay, on top of that, I have created one proxy using the API manager. And I have deployed it in the runtime manager. So let me open this API. And if I go to settings site, we can view one more additional tab, auto scaling. So this is the feature present by the platform out of box for ELA customers. So here you can create a policy. Okay, it's similar to whatever the policy we are creating in the API manager, right? So similarly, we can create a policy in runtime manager for this auto scaling. Let me delete this. And let me click on create policy. Then you can provide the policy name. Let's say, for example, I can provide the API name like horizontal. Okay. And basically, you have two features. Okay, you can scale based on the CPU usage or memory usage. So we can monitor the dashboard and get the metrics, and based on that you can choose between CPU or memory usage. Okay, let's say for example I'm facing some problem in the memory and I'm selecting this, and here I can give the condition for scale up and scale down. So let's say for example if the memory usage is more than 80 for more than 5 minutes, then I need the scaling to be applied. Similarly for scale down, if the memory usage is less than 20 for more than 10 minutes, then I can configure the scaling. Okay, for scale down. Okay, and here you can choose either between a number of free cores or worker size. Okay, and if you choose the number of worker size, then it will be limited between 1 and 4. You can't increase beyond 4. Okay, and if I choose the worker size, then it can between 0.1 and 16, which means the entire set we can choose. Okay, so let's say I'm choosing number of workers and 1 and 4, and if I click on this create right, then automatically a policy will be created, and you can enable or disable this policy at any point of time. Okay, and as I mentioned right, you can either apply horizontal scaling or vertical scaling, but not both, because as you see here right, I have created a horizontal scaling, and after that this trade policy is disabled for me. So which means application cannot have more than one auto scale policy at a point of time. Okay. If I need a vertical scaling, then I need to delete this application and create a new one. Okay. Similarly, on top of this, you can create alerts as well. So say for example, I can create an alert like a horizontal scaling alert for Express. Okay. And I can choose the criticality, and I can add the recipient as well. So whenever the scale up or scale down occurring, right, then the intended recipients will be getting out your mail. And you can view these alerts by clicking on this view associate alerts, and it will show in the runtime manager alerts tab. You can view that as well. Like this.
Yeah. Sridharan, just want to add one, few points here.
Yeah.
So guys, when you're going for horizontal scaling, make sure you have proper configuration. Okay. Horizontal scaling means you are making more servers, right? So if you have in-memory configuration, transient configuration for your VMs, then that won't get leveraged once you are going from one worker to next worker. Okay. So, I mean, it's just like that. You can't go for the horizontal scale. Your application should properly configured that way. Okay, so yes, option is available, but if inside your application you have transient VM, okay, then that won't be used. Okay, if you're going for the horizontal scale, so make sure that one keep in mind. Okay.
Yeah, thanks for adding that, Ashish. Yeah.
Yeah, Stephen, and one question, do we have any benchmark that tell how many number of VCOs and how many number of workers should be there in order to do the auto scaling?
It depends on the use case, okay, and it's recommended to perform a PT before coming up with these worker configurations.
Okay, cool. So I would also like take this time for answering few questions, Sridharan. So one question is from Harneet. We need to configure scaling per API. Do we need to configure scaling per API?
Yeah, it's providing scaling per API alone. And I forgot to mention, this is feature is available only for cloud up, not for on-prem. For on-prem, you need to take care of your own infrastructure.
Okay, good. So another question from Pavan. So auto scaling feature, do we need TP request MuleSoft vendor and to charge any cost based on the memory usage and worker usage?
No, all the memory and worker usage is coming within VCO, right? So it's they will charge based on the number of VCOs you are purchased. That's all.
Okay.
And for this auto scaling, you need to have the ELA license.
Yep. Thanks, Sridharan. That's all for you now. Thank you.
Okay, thanks.
Sridharan, I reference that answer for Pavan actually. Pavan, if you enable auto scaling, you don't need to pay extra because you already paid for the license. It will pick up from your license only. Okay. So it doesn't mean that you enable auto scaling, you need to pay extra. Okay, provided you have ELA license, that's it. Okay, it can go up, it can go down. So number of workers you can add, number of workers can remove. So there is no need to pay extra, provided you have ELA license. Yeah.
Yeah.
Chetan, go ahead.
Yeah, thanks. And one more thing, if you can notice, right? If I apply the horizontal scaling, then I can't be able to change the workers from the runtime settings. Okay. And similarly, if you configure the vertical scaling, then you can't able to change the worker size here. Okay. So if you still need to change this worker size and configuration, then you need to delete this policy and come up here and change the thing. So these are all the features for endpoint platform. Sorry, auto scaling in our platform. Okay. So any other additional questions till now, Anu?
I think we have one more. Does any point platform gives any suggestion for auto scaling based on historical data points? I think no, right?
No.
Yep. Rajiv, at this point, I think.
Yeah, Rajiv, we need to monitor our API performance. So in section there you need to see. Okay, so if it's going beyond your thresholds, you can come here and apply the auto scaling policy.
So we can view the points to be considered. Okay, so before counting the auto scaling, you need to check the performance of the backend system. Okay, because if the backend is performing very slow, right? Then if you scale up or scale out, then it won't have any additional performance improvement. So we need to check the backend system. And if the backend system is responding within the time limit, and if our API is not responding due to CPR memory stress, then we can consider this auto scaling option. And as Ashish mentioned, we need to check on the internal components we are using. As he told, right, for VM transient and all, it's not recommended. So you need to take the threshold into the consideration. So you can apply horizontal or vertical scaling, but not both for a single API. So, and these are all additional features we have seen. In vertical scaling, you can configure between 0.1 and 16 cores. In horizontal, you can configure between 1 and 4 workers. If you still need the, if you have done the PT, okay, I mean the performance testing, and if you are confident that your worker, your application need 6 workers, right, then you can remove this horizontal scaling policy and go ahead and increase the number of workers to 6, because in our platform, you can increase the number of workers to 8, okay?
Yeah. Then, I'd like to stop this point. I think some people have confusion on what horizontal and vertical scaling is. Can you brief about that a bit?
Yeah. So in horizontal scaling, right, which means basically we are adding number of additional workers, okay, or number of servers, okay, so that the load can be distributed among them. Okay. And in vertical scaling, the existing worker configuration will be scaled up. Like, for example, the infrastructure of that particular worker will be increased, like from 0.1 vCore to 0.2 vCore or 0.2 vCore to 1 vCore, like that we can scale up. So that's vertical scaling. Horizontal scaling is so basically adding number of workers so that the load distribution will be done.
Yeah, one more point, guys. There will be questions from the slides in the cow quiz, okay, at the end. So please focus on the slides also, okay? And one more point I'll add to the horizontal scaling, you know, very important point when you are increasing number of workers for your application, high availability will be coming to picture when you do the horizontal scaling. Okay, that's very, very important.
So for services which receive huge number of requests, right, we can go for horizontal scaling, okay, because it will distribute the load between different workers. And for services which involves a huge size of payload, right, then it's recommended to go with the vertical scaling, as it will improve the performance. And before coming to the consideration of this auto scaling, we need to monitor the dashboard, then we need to perform the performance testing, and after that only we can come up with these configuration parameters. So this sums up the auto scaling feature of in our platform. So any other additional questions?
We have a set of questions. So one question is from Harneet. So can we set the upper level of number of workers or number of vCores when we configure auto scaling?
Yeah, you can, but we need to make sure during our runtime, right, your particular business unit or environment is having that much amount of vCores extra, so that it can utilize.
Yep, yep. And one question from Kavi, I think it's already answered. Auto scaling at the same time, both vertical and horizontal, we cannot do, right, at the same time?
Yeah, we can't do.
Can't do. So I think that's all.
Okay, thanks, Anu.
Yep, yep.
Yeah, we can move to next feature. Okay, any point monitoring. So this any point monitoring is one of the monitoring strategy which is used in a Mule application to perform to monitor the API performance. Okay, basically it's useful for the support and application maintenance team because it will enable know us whether the all the lights are turned on, and if at all any failures or anything, we can have some additional checks configured in this any point monitoring. Okay, and we can take care of that. So for this any point monitoring, you will be having the features on you in the trial account as well. But for viewing the all the, I mean, in order to utilize the full capability of this feature in the platform, you need to have your Titanium subscription. Okay. So let me show the. Okay. Let me open the monitoring. This is my org account, which is having Titanium subscription. And this is my trial account. So in trial account, if you see, you'll be having only three things: built dashboard, custom dashboard, alerts. Okay. Whereas in the Titanium subscription, you will be having a lot many features as well. Okay. And in order to make use of this monitoring, right, you need to enable the monitoring and visualization feature. Okay. So basically, you can do it in two places. Okay. So you can go to the runtime manager under settings, you can click on this enable monitoring and visualizer and apply changes. It will redeploy your application, and if this application will start to push the monitoring metrics to the dashboards at regular intervals. Okay, and the one more place where we can enable this feature is in your any point monitoring, there will be a section settings. Okay, and if you choose the cloud hub, right, you can able to select the environment from the drop down, and if you select the environment, it will basically show all the applications which is present in that particular environment. So from here you can either disable or enable this monitoring. So these are the two places where you can enable the monitoring. So in order to make use of the application to be visible in this any point monitoring, you must enable this monitoring option enabled. Okay, then we will move to the built-in dashboard. Okay, so built-in dashboards are the dashboard which is provided by the MuleSoft itself for viewing the metrics related to the application or API level. Okay, so if you open the metrics for API level, then you can view the number of the metrics related to the request, like a request time or number of requests like that. In metrics related to the failures, related to performance, and related to client application. Basically, in client application, you can view from which client ID we have got the request, and from which client IP as well, we have got the request. That as well, you can see. And similarly, in the application dashboard, you can basically view the metrics for these different things: inbound, outbound, flows, connectors, performance. For application network, these are all the different things. Okay, let me just open the routine dashboard for one of the API which I'm having. So this is the only API I'm having, request proxy view. Okay, and if I choose this resource name, right, basically it will show me the API name which is deployed in the API manager, as well as the application name deployed in the runtime manager. So I can choose either of these. First I can choose the API name. Okay, and it will ask me to pick up a API instance. Okay, and if I click on view, right, so these are all the different metrics I can view. So this overview, it will show the metrics on the high level, but basically it will pick this metrics value from the remaining tabs. Okay, and if I click on the request, right, it will show the metrics related to incoming request. How many requests got for by method, okay, then by response code, request size, response size, like this we can see. And these are all, if you see, if you look, this doesn't have any timeline shown here. Okay, but for some of the things there will be a timeline shown. So which means this metric is for the last 1 hour or 1 hour alone. Okay, this URL is being used four times, or called four times the last 1 hour. Okay, and similarly, you can view the failures as well. There are no failures for here, and for failure as well, for the first metric we are seeing here, right? It will show for a last 1 hour. Okay, and other things we can basically navigate and search for different time ranges. Let's say, for example, I need the metric for the last 2 dates. Okay, I can choose the date. It actually takes the local time. Okay, so it's IST for now. It will show the metrics for the last 2 dates in IST. So this won't change because this is for last 1 hour. And whereas if you look, this will get changed. Okay. And similarly, if I want to, let's say here the request by response code is high. Again, I forgot some for not one or something. If I just want to view that, I can just expand it here and view here. Okay. So you have that option as well. Then performance. So it will show the performance based on the incoming path, okay? And it will show the slow request as well. And these are all for the last 1 hour alone. We can't be able to edit that, okay? Then client application, it will show the how many requests came from different client ID and client IP, okay? For this application, I haven't created any client ID. So due to that, it's showing only the this one, okay? And for client IP, it says I have got this request from this client IP 3.82. This is the public IP. Okay, so here I can see that. So these are all the different metrics for API level, and similarly for application level as well, we can monitor. I can select this app name, and if I click right, as we seen, these are all the different metrics we can see: inbound, outbound, flows, connectors. So inbound, it basically covers the metrics from the start to end. Till the time the request reaches the mule and it's sent back from mule. So it covers the entire time range. Okay, and if you see, I have received this many request. Let me change for last date alone. You can see that. Okay, and this is for the response time. So you can view in both the graph gateway as well as the table format. Okay, so these are all the inbuilt one which we can't, which we can view and which we can't edit it. Okay, so it will provide the response time at 99% 90% 75% and 50% as well. Okay. And in the outbound, it will basically tells the how much time it took in the backend. Say for example, in this example, if you look to right, I'm getting a request from the client. Okay, so at the back end, I'm calling this URL request.in. Okay, so it will mention how much time it took in the back end. So you can monitor the metrics at the flow level, for which flow got how much time. So as I mentioned, right, I have created a proxy in API manager. It has only one flow proxy. So this is the time taken for that thing. Okay. Then connectors. So in connectors, you can view the metrics at the connector level. For some of the pre-built connectors, they will be showing the metrics over here. Like for database or Salesforce, these are all predefined connectors. Okay. For that, you can view the metrics over here. And if you use any custom connector, like not custom connector, if you use any other custom any other connectors apart from these predefined, right, then you can view that in other connector request. Okay, so here you can view. And this performance, right, it's basically collects all the different metrics from the previous steps, like inbound, outbound connectors, and it will be populated over here. Here you can view the failures, how much got failed, how many requests per the operation level, per endpoint level like those. Okay. Similarly, you can mount it to the JVM memory. Okay. The GC as well, you can view here. Then similarly, the infrastructure level, how much memory got used, how much CPU placed, like that. Okay. This is custom metric is one of the additional feature. Okay, so you can push the metrics from your application itself. So you need to make use of the AnyPoint custom metric connector, which is present in the AnyPoint Studio. Okay, and there you can configure what all the different metrics you can send from from that application to the dashboard that you can configure during your development. Okay. And this application network will basically show from where I'm getting the request and where this request is being transferred to. I think it's not showing for me now. We can come back here later and check. Sometimes it may show it like this. So these are all the features present in the built-in dashboard. So any questions? Then we can move to the custom dashboard. Okay. So we have seen some of the things in built-in dashboard, right? So it's a predefined and provided by MuleSoft itself. Okay. What if I need to have some custom another kind of metrics? Like say for example. They are showing something in table, right? If I need it in a graph, okay, or if I need some more additional metrics, then you can go for this custom dashboard, okay? In a single custom dashboard, you can configure any number of metrics, okay? So these metrics can be viewed in a graph or table or single stat. And some of the common use cases we can look is we can view the metrics for the APIs present in the single application network. Say for example, if I am having a one experience API which calls two process API and which in turn calls some three system API, right? So this application network consists of this one experience API plus two process API plus three system API, which sums up to six APIs. So instead of if you look into the built-in dashboard, right, it's provide the facility to view the metrics at the application.
Can you go to the connectors? The Bushnu has a question there.
Yeah, yeah.
Are we getting all the connectors over here, or only the connectors used in the flow?
No, it will. This will be a predefined set. Okay, so either if we use it in our application or not, it won't change. Okay, if you look in our application, I have used only the HTTP request. Okay, so it means HTTP connector alone. But if you see, we will be having this thing for Salesforce, database, HTTP, web service consume, FTP, SFTP, SMTP, or the file mail protocol. These are all the different connectors I can show. Okay, if you have configured those connectors in your application, then the metrics will be populated. Else it will show like no data points. And for let's say, for example, I'm having a Workday connector or a JMS. Okay, so those and all will come in the other connector. Yeah. Any other questions? Hope it clarifies.
Yeah, I think we have a couple of questions. One from Chetan. So the question basically says, if we have like only two workers, and if we like configure auto scaling for one of the Mule application, can we able to configure the same auto scaling for another app? Will it work?
You mean at the app level, right? You can configure auto scaling for multiple apps.
Multiple apps, but only if we have two workers, then still it's possible, right?
Yeah, you can configure, but during runtime, if you don't have that availability of records, right, then it will send out an alert mail like auto scaling is not possible as the number of records you are looking for is not available.
Okay, cool. Yep, I think that's it. Pretty much we have answered all the other questions. Yeah.
I want to add a few points here, guys. Here we have seen the matrix, right? So flows matrix and the connector matrix are really, really important when you are drill ground, you know, issues. So flows will be telling you the, you know, very deep, like which flow is actually slowing down your performance, or which connector inside that flow is performing very slow. So these two things are really important when you are drill, you know, digging for any production issue. Okay, or when you are monitoring and then you are seeing that, okay, this API is not performing well. So from that API, which flow is not performing well? Okay, from that flow, which connector is not performing well? Okay, so like that, we can go in deep and, you know, we can find the root cause of your issue. Okay, so that's what, these are two very important in my point of view. Okay, so other things are there, definitely other metrics are useful, but these two guys give you scripts and you know specific area, okay, where you can go and pick it.
And one more question, I forgot his name, but I remember the question. So this where is it? Let me track this down. So when we enable this AnyPoint monitoring capability, right, do we have any performance issues there?
Yeah, definitely. We can have some 3% of performance decrease because it collects and sends the metrics to dashboard, right? So definitely there will be some impact. But it's a trade-off, right? Again, if you just want to make use of the platform effectively and find root cause during the error cases, right? Then you need to have this kind of
capability. Yep.
Yeah. So here, immediately it won't send data to the environment. Okay, to the platform. It, you know, in periodically it will send the data. You collect the data and in one shot it will send. So performance wise, it happens asynchronously. It won't impact your performance that much. Okay. So it happens asynchronously.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, to add to Ashish's point, right, what is ideally happening is, so it's between the runtime and the control plane and the runtime plane, right? So what it actually needs to do when we enable this AnyPoint monitoring capability, there is a mule agent which is getting enabled in the runtime. Okay, and once we enable that mule agent is responsible for sending this all these logs to the control plane where the AnyPoint platform is there. So, and that's why we are seeing all the things in the AnyPoint platform. So when we enable that mule agent, there is a of course a performance degradation there, and but ultimately the small mule agents are responsible for sending the logs information for the control plane. That's why we are also getting this AnyPoint visualizer. If you see the capabilities and all the logs are coming from this mule agent.
Yep. Yeah, thanks for adding that, Ashisano.
Yep.
So coming back to our use case for custom dashboard, right? As I mentioned, say for example, I'm having one experience API, two process API, and three system API. So in the built-in dashboard, if you look, I can view the metrics at the application or API level. Okay, let's say what if I just want to view the metrics in a single place of all these six APIs. Okay, because it will basically allow us to dig deeper and find in which API it's getting the failure or response is bad, like that. Okay, so that's one of the use case where you can use the custom dashboard. And another use case which I think in my mind is, let's say for example, you are having one application consumer, okay? And they are looking for some metrics to be populated, to be sent for every 4 hours or something. Okay, let's say they are looking for the number of requests being processed in the last 4 hours, then number of failures, like that, okay? So you can very well go ahead and view that in the built-in dashboard and provide that, and but it will be in different tabs, right? Inbound and failures, like that. So what you can do is you can go to the custom dashboard. You can create a single dashboard with one metric for inbound, I mean number of requests, and another metric for number of failures like that as well. You can do. Basically, I will now show how the custom dashboards will be created. Okay, how it will be look like. So you can choose the dashboard metric type in which view you need to look. Either it's a graph or single stat or table or text. Actually, text is for giving the title like that. Okay. So mostly we will be using these three things. Okay. Let's say graph. Okay. Here you can go and click on configure. Then you can choose the application name and the resource name. Actually, I'm having only one application deployed, so it's showing this one. And then the metric as well, you can choose between the different metrics for inbound or the CPU or the JVM, okay? Then for outbound or failures. So these are all different metrics you can take, okay? Let's say I'm interested in looking at the number of failures, okay, for endpoint, okay, for this application. So let me choose this. And click on apply changes. Okay. Save it. Okay. So a dashboard will a metric is added to this dashboard. You can add the name. Okay. Let's say there is a failure came. Okay, which means that will be logged in here. Okay, and the request will be like here. Then after that, I can go to alert. Okay, I can add the alert for the failures, severity level, whatever you can choose. If it's above one in the last 5 minutes, then send the notification to this people with this notification message. Like that, you can configure. Okay, so this is how you can configure this custom dashboard. Say I'm interested in the average number of incoming request. Okay, so these are the number of requests which is coming in. So like this, you can play with these different metrics, but for your use case, you can do this. Okay, I can click on apply changes, then I can add one more row, single stat. I can go and configure. So, I can give like number of requests, select the environment, and this resource, apply changes. So, if you see, these are the number of requests which came. Okay. And I can move this to up or down. I can reduce the size as well. So this is how you will be configuring your custom dashboards. So any doubts?
Yeah, the one question. This endpoint monitoring capability is environment based?
This will be at the business unit level. Okay.
Business unit level. Yeah.
So if you look at this is my demo business unit, and if I click here, I can basically choose between the different environments present in that business unit.
But yeah, Rajiv's question was, can we have the settings configured in all the environments? I mean, can we able to copy the settings actually?
This is the single place, okay? So you can go ahead and view the metrics for all the dashboards in your single monitoring page. And similarly, you can create the custom metrics for all your environments in your single dashboard. And it also provides the flexibility to add the or view the metrics of different environments as well in your single place. Say, for example, you need to monitor the metrics for your both UAT and prod. So you can configure one metric for a sandbox, one for UAT, one for prod, like that you can have.
Okay, cool. And have a couple of questions. from Kavi. Do we need to create a custom dashboard for each metrics?
No, in a single dashboard you can create a number of metrics, and as I mentioned, it's according to your need. So it's according to your use case. For one use case, you can create a one custom dashboard, and in that you can configure a number of metrics.
Yep. In one question from Bushno, can we have the data from the custom dashboard? Can we have data from MuleApp payload?
No. So basically, for viewing the metrics, we can't access the logs. For accessing the logs, we will discuss the log management feature.
Yeah,
Bushnu, if you want a specific data from the MuleApp payload, then there is a custom matrix, okay? So you need to send that data. You need to have a component inside your MuleApp. Otherwise, there is no way, okay? So if you are like KPIs, let's say, for example, from the payload, you wanted to see that, let's say you are insurance API, okay? So you wanted to see like how many policies you have sold till now. So you wanted to see that count, okay, always on your dashboard. Or what is the average amount the policy you sold it. Those things are KPIs that will be coming from your payload only, right? So if you have that component inside your application, then you can send that data to the dashboard. But it adds the performance, okay? So always you can't be keep that active, okay? So that's you need to be very careful.
So let's move to the next topic, reports. Okay, so in reports tab, which present in the Unified monitoring, right, it basically allows the users to view and pull the metrics for applications deployed in the environment at the current business unit level. Okay, so these are all the KPIs which should be needed for the high level management, and this can be used for the platform team as well to ensuring the application availability. Okay, and you will be having a feature to pull these reports and export it as a CSV as well. And these are the different reports you can view using this reports feature. Okay, so let me go here. And for these reports, right, you need to select the environment level. So I'm having an application running in Sandbox alone. So let me choose that. And if I click on view, it will basically provide the metrics regarding to requests, performance, failures, CPU and memory utilization. Okay, and you can choose this metrics to be viewed for the last 24 hours or 7 days, 15 or 30 or 90 days. Here you can't change this time as we have shown in our built-in or custom dashboard. Okay, so and you can also export it as a CSV and store it in your system. Okay, like that you also can view. So this shows how many requests generated and how many are successful. Okay, and performance, how much time it took, average response time. Then the number of failures in the last 7 days, how much your CPU got replaced, how much memory got replaced, and what's the memory pressure. It basically provides the memory utilization by total allocated memory. That will be your memory pressure. Yeah. So the next one is alerts. So we have covered it in the custom dashboard partially, okay? So in any point monitoring, right, you can basically create two types of alerts, basic and advanced alert. And I think if you have a trial account, you can configure only this basic alert, okay? So in any point platform, right, basically we can create alerts in three places, okay? So one is API manager, then runtime manager, the third comes the endpoint monitoring. Okay, API manager, you can configure the alert based on the number of requests or the response code, like that. Okay, and in runtime manager, you can configure the alerts based on the deployment failure, success, CPU and memory utilization, then you can have a custom notification connector also enabled in your application and capture those as well in your runtime manager and show to consumers. Okay, so it's basically right. It's basically making use of the alerts we will be having in API and runtime manager, right? Mostly it will make use of that. So I can choose the environment, then the resource name, and in the metric you can choose the message count, number of error messages, response time, CPU, memory utilization, thread count. So it basically provides the metrics of present in the API or runtime manager level. Okay. Then you can add the recipients, and once you click on the create, and whenever the alert condition occurs, right, it will send out a mail to stakeholders. Then comes the advanced alert. So in order to make use of the advanced alert, you need to have a custom dashboard created with some metrics. And you can configure the alert in the custom dashboard as we have seen. So coming back here, see configure in the alert when it when the failure reaches greater than one in the past 5 minutes. Then in the notification, you can add the notification message and to whom this notification has to be sent. You can configure those things. It will come in the alerts tab. Is there any questions till now, or we can move to the next feature?
I think most questions are answered. So one question is from Bhushan, is like Cloud Up has maximum 30 days validity, right, for the logs, but any point monitoring is giving us 90 days. So so when we enable the any point monitoring, does the Cloud Up logs also will be 90 days or 30 days?
No, in runtime manager we can view the logs for the last 30 days or up to 100 MB, which is which comes first. But in any point monitoring, we can view the logs even for the previous time as well.
Cool.
Then comes the functional monitoring. Okay. So we'll just show what the functional monitoring is. So functional monitoring is a framework present in the platform, okay, which helps us to understand the reliability and the quality of the APIs which is being used in our application network. Okay, so you can monitor the APIs in regular intervals using some scheduler, okay, and send the notifications to the people in case if the API is failing with some unexpected error or something. Okay, so as I mentioned here, right, the public and private API. So the private API is something which is deployed in to your Anypoint VPC Cloud Hub, and it's accessible only to the internal or intranet. Okay. Whereas the public API is the APIs that are deployed in the cloud and which is accessible to anyone. Okay. Let's say, for example, I have created one application, right? The Rectrace. Okay. This is deployed into my VPC. So we can say it is a private one. Okay. And if it's accessible only from my VPC, it's private. Okay. Whereas if you look here, right, this is a public API because it can be accessed from outside as well. Okay. Then public location, private location. Okay. So public location is a region. Okay, which will be shared with other MuleSoft customer as well. So currently, MuleSoft is providing this public location accessible from two different regions, like US East 1 and US East 2. Okay, and you can configure this monitoring interval to for every 15 minutes. Okay, and there's a limitation, like you can configure up to max of 5 monitors per organization. Okay, and coming to private location. Private location is something which I can deploy in my Anypoint VPC. Say, for example, if I'm having a API okay, running in my Anypoint VPC, and it will be accessed only by the application which is running in my Anypoint VPC. So with this public location, I can't be able to access, right? So in that case, I need to create a private location, which means basically I need to deploy or create a worker in my VPC, okay, and made it to be up and available. And user can create a number of private locations within a VPC. And by default, if you create a private location, right, it will take the worker configuration of 0.2 vCore into one worker. And the shortest interval you can configure is 5 minutes, okay? And for this, for a single private location itself, you can configure any number of APIs to be monitored. Let me show it here. So I have created two monitors here, okay? So one is for the proxy API, this one, and another is for the backend endpoint, which is this one, okay? If I click on this, you can view the schedules. It's running for every 15 minutes, and the next time is in the next 6 minutes. And if you look in the execution location, right, it's running in EOS East 1, okay? And if you click on the monitored endpoints, we can view which endpoint we are monitoring. So this is the endpoint we are monitoring now. Okay. And in the test, here it will show how many paused or failed in the last 5 executions. And here it will say how much time it took during different things. So here for DNS resolution, it took 9 milliseconds, connecting 40 milliseconds. For SSL 0, receive 1 millisecond, like this, you can view at this level, okay? And if you click on this edit, right, here only we will be configuring the endpoints and provide the monitor name. So I have provided this request endpoint, okay? And the endpoint URL is this one, and the expected status code I can provide, okay? So which means this is the successful criteria. And if the expected status code is deviated from this 200 OK, then we will be receiving email for overall the users are configured here. Okay? So you can configure email or Slack or New Relic or all those things. Okay. Then similarly, this is for the dual proxy. So this is the endpoint we are monitoring for the proxy application. Then schedules, which is a available to run in next 7 minutes. Then here you can view the URL which is being configured. And if you have any header to be added, you can add it here. Similarly, the mails you can add. Let me show from the scratch itself. Okay, some demo monitor. Okay. Then if you see, there are two types of editors supported. One is basic and another is advanced. So in basic, you can monitor only one endpoint, okay? Whereas in the advanced, you can monitor any number of endpoint. And the basic, if you see, right, the expected status code allowed, you can verify. Whereas in the advanced one, I can provide some endpoint URL, and then the status code, as I can assert, and I can add assertion for response body. Body has to contain this value. Then I can assert the response header as well. In the header, if there is a header value, then it has to be this value, like that as null, we can check, okay? And similarly, as I mentioned, right, the execution location, it's public or private. So I have made use of public here. You can create a private location as well. If your application is deployed in VPC and it's not accessible by anyone outside of your network, then you can use the private location, okay? And you can schedule the monitor interval as well. Every 15 minutes or hourly, okay? And once you click on next, then a monitor will be created, and it keeps on monitoring the endpoints you have configured over here. So, any questions till now?
I think one question we had, functional monitoring only HTTP endpoint, can we use other other endpoints. So I didn't
unfortunately, for now, the platform supports only HTTP, HTTPS. For other things, there's no support.
Yep. That's it, I believe. Yeah, we're good. Yeah.
So with this, we have covered the features in the monitoring thing. Okay. Let's move on to the log management features. Okay. So log management. So this is one of the additional features present by the endpoint platform for Titanium customers. Okay. So this will be very much helpful for support and maintenance point of view, because you can view the logs in the log management for more than 30 days or 100 MB as well, because in runtime manager you will be having this restriction for 100 MB or 30 days. Okay. And similarly, you can download the logs as well. Okay. In runtime as well, you can go to your runtime manager and download the logs. Let's say, I think here they have added one more feature, like new logs. New logs will be your system logs, okay? Then you can go to logs and download. It will download all the logs into your local, okay? And you can view the diagnostics as well, okay? But in any point monitoring, and I say right, this can be kept for last 30 days or up to 100 MB. What if the if you need to view some of the logs on the last month or something, okay? Then you can make use of this log management feature. Okay, so in log management, you can store the logs up to 200 GB per core, sorry, per core for prod, and 50 GB for a non-prod core. Okay, and you can search or filter the logs with some string or a time interval or the priority in the runtime manager. But in any point monitoring, you can filter the logs based on the worker as well, then the log level, then the timestamp, then the message, string, application, etc. And one more thing is, in runtime manager, you need to view the logs per application level. But for monitoring, you can view the logs across all the applications, across all the environments present in the particular business unit. Okay. So it's one of the cool features, because say for example, if I am having one Experience API, two Process API, and three System API, okay, and something got failed. If I have access only to my runtime manager, then I need to go to each and every API and search it with some new event ID or correlation ID. But whereas in unified monitoring, right, I can paste that correlation ID here, okay, and I can search it with the correlation ID, and I can get the logs starting from the Experience API, Process API, System API, in ascending order. So the first come first. So the Experience API log will be logged here, then the Process, System, then the then the messages coming to Process, Experience, all those things we can view in a single place. So this is a most very good feature present in the log search module. Okay, and I can search it based on the application name, then the class, environment, log level, then the timestamp, worker level as well. I can able to search. Okay, let's say for example, I'm searching something called a listener. So it will provide for that particular string alone, and I can choose the interval. Let's say for example, I need these logs for the entire day of yesterday. I can choose this, and I will get the logs for this particular search string. Okay, here. And one more additional cool feature we are having is you can save the search, share the search to other people as well. Say for example, if you are working in your application maintenance team, okay, you need to hand over the issue to someone else in your team. Okay, you have viewed something in the log, and you have made sure that this is from this log alone, we need to search for something and to get the root cause. Then you can save this search, okay, like a listener. Like this, I can save it, okay, and I can take it from the search anytime. Okay, and if you need to share this whatever that you have searched to someone else, right, you can go ahead and click on share. It will provide some URL. You can copy this URL and share to your application maintenance team. Then they can take out from there and see. And in the save search, we can view the saved searches as well. So these are two different things I have searched. Let's say example, I have came to shift just now, okay, and one of my fellow maintenance team member has left his shift and by providing this query search, okay, then I can make use of this, and I can see on 21st of June, okay, how many 401 error it came, like that, and all we can view. So as I mentioned, logs can be investigated, filtered, then it can be shared and viewed and saved, etc. Okay. Then comes the next feature, log points. So let's take a real-time example. Okay, you are having one application running in production. Okay, and suddenly got failed. It's getting failure from somewhere. Okay, and you need to check into the root cause. You are having some database connector or HTTP listener or whatever it may be, and you want to view the logs. Okay, then now what you will do is you need to go to the application and add some debug logs and deploy, right? So instead of that, you can make use of this log points. Actually, this is a codeless feature present by the MuleSoft platform. You can select the environment and the application name, and if you click on I will come back later. Actually, you can view it API level as well. I will come back later. Let's say application level. You can choose the resource name, click on view. Then it will basically show me what are the different components for which I can apply that log level. Okay, so these are all the predefined connectors. Okay, even if you use in your application or not, it will come here, and according to your configuration, whether what's the level of configuration debug you are choosing, then the debug log will be entered. Let's say, for example, I don't have this debug module. Okay, let's click on save and apply. This also you click and apply. Okay, so actually, it won't do a redeployment, it will just refresh the page. Okay, and just now I have received some failures from my application running in the prod. So I know that I am having only a HTTP connector running in this because it's basically a proxy, right? So I can click on this HTTP connector, select the log level, then click on save and apply. Okay. Then if you look, it will just refresh, and for the subsequent request you are hitting, right, you will be getting the log level with the debug. Okay, let's try to hit it from here. I'm getting some response, and if you look, the log level is debug for this. We are getting the debug logs. Okay, and you can view this in the settings as well. In the logging, there will be additional properties added. Okay. So these three are all for the HTTP connector logs. So this is the feature present in the application level. Okay, but we need to make sure once the root cause is found and we have fixed that issue, then it's always advisable to go and change the log level to info or warn and click on save and apply, because it will have some application performance impact. Okay, so similar to connectors, connector level in the application, right, you can configure the log points in the API level as well. Okay, let's select the API and the API ID. So in some cases, if you just want to view in logs from which host or from which IP I am getting the request, okay, you can go ahead and under request header, you can choose these properties or what are the properties you are interested in, and say click on save apply. So if you look here, right, for some of the, for all the requests which I'm sending, I will be receiving the logs for this header as well. So this is API users, then this from this remote IP, I'm getting this request. This is the path which is being used. So all these things I can view. Okay. So this is the feature of the codeless logging, because we are not doing any code and deploying the application. Instead, the platform is providing an option wherein we can add the properties, okay, and click on. And after clicking on save and apply, we can able to do the features. So similarly, you can log the request body, then the response header. If you are interested in some of the properties, then you can choose that. If you want all, then you can click here. Similarly, in response body as well, you can do the same. So for any questions, Anu?
Yeah. So we have one question from Kavi. So he's asking about the custom metrics which is present under monitoring. So what is a high level use of it? Can you brief it?
Yeah, it's the same as what Ajish mentioned, right? If you want to view some of the metrics at the business level, say for example, a flight booking, okay? You want to just view from which region the flight booking requests are coming at the high level, okay? Then in your any point studio while you are developing your application, you can capture the source and destination of the searches, okay? And you can push that into a custom metric connector in your Anypoint Studio. And after that, you can make use of these metrics in the custom dashboard, and you can view that from there.
Sure. Yep. Okay. Thank you. So one question from Bhushan. Is there any size limit for log message? So, he has seen it's getting trimmed in some big payload things.
Yeah. Whatever the logs you are viewing in the runtime manager, right? The same you can view it in any point monitoring as well. Basically, it will make use of the log4j to XML. Okay. It will add the appender so that the logs will be sent to both the runtime manager as well as the endpoint monitoring. So it's same log which will be viewing the runtime manager. Yeah, I have seen some for huge payloads, so we will be getting some trimmed or truncated kind of message at the end, dot dot dot. But I'm not sure on the exact message size till how much the platform will support.
Sure. And one question from Bhushan itself is: log management shows different and detailed log from system logs and worker logs from runtime management. You want me to read the question once again?
Yeah.
Yeah. So he's asking: is this log management shows different and detailed log from system log and worker log from runtime management?
No, it will basically shows the application logs which is present in the runtime manager. Yeah.
Sure. Cool. Great. I think we can continue at this point.
Yeah. So the next comes the last feature, raw data. Okay. Say for example, you just want to download the data, right? Log management, you don't have the logs that you don't have that option. You can view the logs, then you can manually copy the logs like this and paste it in your local or some kind of like that. Okay, whereas in raw data, you can literally download the log message into your local. Okay, for that, you need to know the application name and at which time the time interval which you are interested to fetch the logs. So, let's say I'm taking this environment in this application, clicking on view, and I can choose the date. Okay, here we don't have much flexibility to change the timestamp level. Okay, but we can filter based on the workers. And if you look the logs log names and the different sizes will be shown here. And let's say I just want, I'm interested in taking the logs which came on 3:14. Okay, this is the time. I can click on download, so it will download the log in my local, and after that I can make use of this one. So this is the feature which I will see now. Yeah, with this we come to the end. So if you still have any questions, and put it in the chat. Okay. If not, you can directly reach me up to in LinkedIn as well.
Yep, sure. We have few more questions. So again from Bhushan, lock point is applicable only for API, Mule app as well.
Yeah, it's applicable at the API as well as the application level. So once you go to the lock points, right, you can, if you choose the API name, then it will ask for the version or instance ID. But if you choose the application name, you can directly go ahead and add the log level for different connectors.
Cool.
When we are going for app level, right, it's very useful. No. Sometimes we forgot that what package for HTTP, what package name for file connectors. If you come here, right, it will be very useful. If we go to setting here, right, you need to be, see, if you want to enable, right, debug level for some particular package, right, you need to go to the documentation and see what exactly the package name for HTML, HTTP or DB, right? But if you go to that log points, here, if you simply select that, it's more readable here, okay? That's what my point.
Yep.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, so if we are, if you don't have any questions, Anu?
Yep.
No more questions, right?
No, we are good.
Okay, guys. So thanks, Ridharan. Thanks for the detailed session. Okay. So hope that is useful for. So there is a question called, if we have multiple HTTP connector, is it possible to log only to specific HTTP connector? I don't think so.
No, it's not possible.
That is not possible. Yeah, I don't see that. Okay, Bhushnu, that is not possible. Okay. Yeah. Okay, so we go ahead with the quiz session. So before starting the quiz, there are some conditions, I would say. So for the attendees, if you have in last 30 days we have attended and won the voucher, so please give chance to other people. Okay, and if you are a speaker or if you are a leader for some meetup, right, please give chance to other guys, because anyway, if you have won the voucher in last 30 days, Mulesoft won't give you, even if you win. Okay, so better if we give chance to other guys. That would be good for more people to have benefit from the meetups, right? Yeah. So let me, if you don't have any questions, I move on with the quiz. Thanks, Murli. Thanks for that feedback. So let me start sharing my screen. Okay. So I'll go ahead and share my screen.
So all credits goes to Sridharan.
Yep.
Sridharan, it was a good one. Thank you.
Yeah, thanks Ashish for providing this opportunity.
Yeah. So let me go ahead and share my screen. So this is screen one. Okay. And hope you are able to see my screen. I'll go to Anu. Can you give me a check mark if you are able to see?
Yes, I'm able to see your screen.
Okay. So, count. It's count dot. Just a second. Just a second, guys. Anup, can you help me with the Kahoot? Because yeah, I'm sharing my screen now. I am logged in. So let's try.
No, Sanjay. Yeah. So we're checking on an issue here. Yeah. Give me a second.
Yeah. You're able to see my screen now?
Yes.
Okay. So let's go ahead and play. So which option we supposed to select?
Okay. I'm not really sure.
Just a second.
It's a student one, I think.
Yeah.
I think it's a student show. I remember she's saying it's a student one.
Yeah, student one.
I'm sure.
Okay, guys. So you, from your mobile, go to the www.kahoot.it, and I'll copy this pin in the chat window. So you are open for just.
I will also try to log in from mobile.
Yeah, please go ahead. The people are. So I'll wait for the attendees. I could see 46 attendees are there. We'll wait for. Try to give a proper name, guys. Okay, don't use your nicknames because, So Noob, Nashab.
That's me.
Okay. Okay. Are we done? I could see 46, 44 guys are there. Ashish, we can find the recording. Sandhya, it will be there on the event page. End of the day will be posted there, okay? Yeah, so let me lock the quiz now and then we start. Okay, 33 guys are there. Let's go ahead. Now let's start. Yeah, please read the questions properly, guys. Okay. And then yeah, the right answer is visualizer. Alerts cannot be created from which component? Okay, that is visualizer. Okay, so let's see. Tarun daughter is leading. Okay, Bhushan and John. Okay. Okay, enabling the debug log will impact the application performance. True or false? So that answer is true. Let's see who's leading. Tarun, Bhushan, John, still these three guys are leading. Okay, let's see. Satya, Devendra.
False custom dashboard.
Which of the following is false, guys? Okay. Let's see who is leading. Okay.
Kadirisan.
Yep.
Points can be enabled.
We have discussed this point in chat window. You answered also. Go ahead, guys. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 1, 0. Yeah. Satya, Tarun, and Ajay. Which statement is true? Satya, Raja Lakshmi, Kalyani.
The statement is true.
Last question, guys. Come on. Okay. Let's see. Congratulations, Satya. Congratulations, Tarun.
Who's
leading? Rajalakshmi. Congratulations, all three guys. Guys, please share your email IDs in the chat window. Anup, can you note down three?
Yep.
Tarun, Rajalakshmi, and Satya. Thank you, guys. You took the screenshot also, Anup?
Yes, yes, I have taken it.
Okay. Thank you, guys.
Satya, Rajalakshmi, and who else? One more guy, right? You need to give the email address where your training account is configured. Yep. So if you give the other email, any other email, it won't work.
Yeah. So guys, make sure you either you create a training account with this email ID, or if we already have that. Okay. Yeah, Satya. Yeah, please give us the right. Okay, Tarun. Okay.
Yep, I'll take the other one.
Yeah, Rajalakshmi. Okay, thank you so much, guys. Yeah. Yeah. And finally, thanks, Shridharan. So you got the Anu?
Yes, Satya and Rajalakshmi got one more. I need to get it.
Tarun. I think he DM you directly.
Oh.
Yeah, just check.
Okay. Yeah. Thanks, Tarun. Yeah, I'll get it from there. Yeah, got it. Cool. Thank you, guys. I appreciate. Yep. Thank you. So do send us the feedbacks, and that's important to us. Satya, I've taken note of that, the new email address you sent me.
Yeah. And finally, the people are already leaving. Just wanted to share the last slide. Okay. So, so next, we go ahead and start spreading the words, okay, with the Ash Coimbatore MuleSoft Meetup. And if you are really interested in, our speaker kind of thing, if you are topic, yeah, please let us know. We'll start helping you guys come forward and post your topic. And then we have coming sessions. So one session by myself on SSL, two-way SSL, one-way SSL. Okay, and then one more sessions on platform, any point platform CLI. Okay, so this session should be coming in the July 3rd and then next on July 17th. Okay, so yeah. And as Anup said, right, feedback is really important. Please, that is like a bread and butter for the meetup. So please give us the feedback. Please write your feedback. Okay. Yeah, that's all from my side, and that's all from our side. Okay, thank you so much.
Yep. Thank you, guys. Appreciate it. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you, guys. Thank you all.
Yep.
Bye.
Bye. I'll stop the recording.
Yes, sir.
You want to take the screenshot?
Yeah. Just a second. Done.
Yep. Cool. Thank you.